I'm about to tell you the story of a guy who went from being a broke limo driver who is stuck living at his mom's house to just a few years later being a multi-millionaire and fulfilling his childhood dream of owning a Lamborghini. And he made his first $1 million at the age of 31. So if you're the kind of person who's thought that maybe you like to make money while you're still young, rather than having to wait until you're 70 years old and in a wheelchair to be able to enjoy your life, then you're going to want to pay close attention to what I have to say in this video. The story I'm going to tell you is about a guy named MJ DeMarco, as he tells in his book, The Millionaire Fast Lane, which I will put a link in the description if you want to check out that book. It's awesome and I highly recommend it. Anyway, MJ was unimpressed with the normal advice that most people give you, that you should work a steady job and climb the corporate ladder, and then maybe when you're 65, then you'll have enough money invested in the stock market that you can actually be rich and buy that Corvette and actually enjoy your life. He calls it wealth in a wheelchair. So he wanted to provide an alternative, and that's why he wrote this book. So I'm going to tell you what is his story. MJ started out as a fat, lazy teenager living with his mom and really didn't do much of anything. He watched TV, he played video games, and he ate ice cream. That was like his whole life story. But one day his life changed because he got off the couch to go to his favorite place, the ice cream shop, and as he was arriving to the ice cream shop, he saw a guy who was about 25 years old exiting the ice cream shop and getting into a brand new Lamborghini. And he is always had this fantasy about Lamborghinis, and he was amazed to see this guy who's only 25 years old getting into a Lamborghini. And he managed to summon the courage to go up to the guy and ask him what he did for a living, and the guy said that he was an inventor, which was a surprise to him. He was thinking that the guy was a pro athlete or a guy was a rock star, something like that. But that changed his life because he recognized that he could do the same thing, right? He wasn't athletic, he wasn't physically gifted, he wasn't musically gifted, right? He had no way of getting famous, he wasn't born rich, but he could be an inventor. Right, he could use his mind to make a lot of money and achieve his lifelong dream of having a Lamborghini as a young man because he had already seen a young man that had done it. So that had been in the back of his mind ever since his teenage years. Now, fast forward to age 26, Marco was broke and struggling. He had a series of stupid odd jobs and he was living with his mother. He had various jobs as a bus boy, as a day laborer, as a delivery driver, and as a limo driver. All of these jobs with not very much pay and crappy hours, which I totally understand because before I started working for myself, I had a big long list of odd jobs like that too, and yes, they suck. They don't pay much, your hours constantly change so you can't make plans. It's a horrible way to live. But while he was working those crappy jobs, he was on a quest to study people who met a very specific qualification that he wanted to learn how they got where they are. And those people were the self-made millionaires who became millionaires when they were young. Not because they were born into it, but because they earned the money themselves, and not through any special talents like being super athletic and being a pro athlete or being a famous singer or something like that. Just normal people who had managed to kind of hack the system and become rich while they were still young. So he read books, he read magazines, he read newspapers, he watched documentaries, all to try to kind of pick out these common themes about how these people managed to achieve this kind of success. That was his quest while he was still stuck doing these stupid odd jobs so that he could learn what they had done right and he could be able to replicate it for himself. And he did this for a while and didn't really have much success. He tried a whole bunch of different business opportunities, got sucked into some scams sometimes, like I talk about in this video, how there's always this balance between being too trusting and too skeptical. Well, he was definitely on the too trusting side, which is, as I mentioned in that video, I think it's better to be too trusting than too skeptical, because even though he got scammed, he eventually made it. So, it worked out on balance. But the more and more these different business opportunities failed him, the more and more depressed he got, the more and more he doubted himself, and the more and more the people around him started to give up on him. His girlfriend dumped him because he couldn't make anything work and he was just working these stupid jobs. She thought that he was just a dead end in life. And he lived with his mother, and his mother was constantly telling him to go get a job, trying to go get him to get a real job and give up on his dreams of actually being rich while he was still young. And then finally, one moment in his life while he was 26 years old, he finally reached a breaking point where he was driving a limo in the Chicago winter and he got stuck in a blizzard. And he couldn't move. He couldn't drive the car anymore because the snow was so bad. So he pulled off to the side of the road. And as he sat there, completely miserable in the Chicago winter, working this crappy job that he hated, he decided that he was going to get out of there. He was going to change his environment completely. He was going to get the hell out of Chicago and find a new place that wasn't so miserable. As he was sitting there on the side of a road in the middle of a blizzard, he made that commitment to himself that now was the time. He was just going to get out of Chicago and change his environment and do something else. And that one decision ended up changing his life. And a lot of us find ourselves in that situation, right? Eventually we hit a point where we're so rock bottom that something has to change and we have to do something differently. And we think at the time that that bad experience is harming us, but actually as we learn after time passes, that's actually the best thing that could have ever happened to us. And if you always have that attitude looking forward, you'll find your life gets a lot easier. Like I describe in this video, you recognize that everything that happens to you is actually happening for you. You have to have that faith. So MJ finally made that commitment to himself. He said that he was going to get out of there, whatever it took. So as soon as he got home, he started researching where he wanted to go. And he came up with a few locations and finally settled on Phoenix, Arizona, where it was sunny for most of the year. He wouldn't have the seasonal affective disorder he was suffering from in Chicago. He could get away from the people in his life that were bad influence. And so he took the plunge. He moved to Phoenix with just $900 and his old beat up Buick Skylark and hundreds of books that he'd collected over the years. By the way, if you're finding this video helpful or interesting, please do me a big favor. Hit the thumbs up icon so that YouTube likes me better, and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell beside the subscribe button so that you get all my future videos, because I got a lot of great stuff coming out soon. Okay, so when MJ got to Phoenix, his whole life changed, right? His mood was better. He didn't have all this bad energy around him from the people that were trying to drag him down, the people that had no faith in him. It was wonderful for lifting his depression and his self-doubt and all this stuff that he was having to deal with. And it's a lot like what I describe in this video, all about how you can change your environment for success. I mean, wherever you are in the world, whatever your financial situation, there's always something you can do to improve your environment. So check out that video if you want to learn more about that. Anyway, so he started doing some web businesses, and in those days he had to design the website himself. He didn't have ClickFunnels or those drag and drop editors like we use today. So he learned to code websites, and the businesses didn't work so well, but he actually got a reputation for being good at building websites just because he had taught himself. By the way, he had been to college for 5 years and it did him no good at all, right? He was getting these stupid odd jobs as a limo driver, etc., after 5 years of college and finally graduating. So, you know, if you're thinking that college is going to help you be successful in life, you're dead wrong. As I can attest to myself, I have a bachelor's degree and a master's degree, both in business, and it really hasn't done anything for me as far as being an entrepreneur, as far as being successful. I mean, the only thing that it's good for is helping you a little bit to get a reliable job, and it doesn't really help you very much because everybody has a college degree now. I like to call a college degree a certificate of mediocrity because it doesn't show anything positive about you, except that you were willing to sit in a chair and follow directions for 4 years. Now, 2/3 of millennials have college degrees, so even in the job market, they're basically worthless. Just about any skill that's going to actually serve you in life, you can teach yourself a lot faster, a lot better, a lot more efficiency, and a whole lot cheaper just on the internet teaching yourself than you can by going to college. Like I talk about in this video, 5 high-income skills that you can teach yourself in just 2 weeks. So MJ taught himself web design, and turns out there's a lot of companies that were interested in web design. So even though the sites he was designing for his businesses didn't work out so well, it turned out that a lot of companies were impressed with his site design, so they came to him to build websites for him, and he did that, and he started actually making real money. And this was pretty exciting for him because this is the first time that he was actually making decent money. But he realized that there is still a problem, and that was that he was still trading his time for money, right? He was still working to build these websites and he got paid for his work. He wasn't getting passive income. It wasn't really scalable. And if you want to make the kind of money that you need to make to have a Lamborghini by the time you're 30, well, you need to get a scalable income source. Now, one of the best ways to create a successful business is to find a need from somebody that is not being filled and fill that need for a price. MJ happened to identify just one such need while he was still a limo driver. Somebody had asked him while he was in Chicago, while he was driving the limo for somebody, he asked if he knew any good limo companies in New York. And back in those days, the internet wasn't quite so big as it is now, where you can just type in limo company in New York in Google and give you all that information. Back then, he would have had to get his hands on a phone book from New York while he was in Chicago, which is kind of difficult to do. So MJ recognized that there was this need for people to identify limo companies in other cities than the city that they're already in, so he created a website that would do this. And that website took off, and finally his income started to grow exponentially. And he was working 60-hour weeks, but since no longer was his income actually tied to his work, he was working for the love of it because he wanted to build his business. Then eventually, somebody offered to buy his business from him for $1.2 million. So he did it. He sold the business, and overnight, he'd become a millionaire. Once he sold the business, he still kept watching it because, you know, it was his baby, and he watched as the Ivy League MBAs ran his business for him, and they completely ran it into the ground. They ruined it and made it completely unprofitable. And, you know, I can tell you from experience that getting an MBA, like I have, is not particularly helpful if you want to be able to run a business in the modern era, because everything that you can possibly learn in college is already well out of date. So the so-called experts, in any credentialed sense, usually are not as capable as they think they are. Anyway, so he watched them run his old business into the ground, and then finally they gave up on the business and offered to sell it on the market for $250,000, and MJ, not wanting to see his baby die, went and bought back the business for a fifth of what he had sold it for. And then, after a while of owning the business himself, he managed to turn it around and it became profitable again. In fact, it became so profitable that he was earning $100,000 to $200,000 a month in profit. So, at that kind of earnings, it didn't take long for him to become a multi-millionaire, and then he finally achieved his childhood dream when he bought a brand new Lamborghini Diablo when he was 33 years old. And he said that after he bought that Lamborghini, he had people constantly coming up to him and asking how he did it, like what he did for a living, how he managed to make that much money, just like he did when he was a teenager and he saw the guy that was the inventor who had a Lamborghini. And so he decided that instead of just giving a one-word answer and driving off, he was going to say exactly what he did, exactly how he went from being broke and useless to finally being a multimillionaire with a Lamborghini. In this book called The Millionaire Fast Lane, again, I will put in the link description below, this book is his answer to everybody who has that question for him. And I don't have time to get into what the book says, but the book goes into great detail about how to start a business that can make anyone rich within a few years, even if you don't have any skills, even if you're not physically talented, even if you're not super intelligent, even, you know, if you can't sing an American Idol. These are the rules and the principles that MJ DeMarco has learned over the years through his failures and through his successes about how to be rich while you're still young, what he calls the fast lane, as opposed to the slow lane, where you work for 40, 50 years, and then once you finally retire, then you can kind of be rich. So if you want to read the book, I totally recommend it. And if it so happens that you don't have a whole lot of money now, maybe you're totally broke, or maybe you're just in a normal job making a normal salary, there's a bunch of ways that that can actually work for you. The fact that you don't have a whole lot of money to spend, a whole lot of money to invest, can actually make you more successful in business. And that's something that I describe in detail in this video. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please let me know in the comments. Let me know if you want me to share more stories of people like this who managed to become successful in a short period of time. And of course, as always, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss anything.